Well, maybe you're heading to college for the first time, or you're striking out on your own with that first job. Well, odds are that maybe you'll be living with a roommate. Even odd couples can get along if they have some good etiquette guidelines to go by. Our expert, Carrie Sue Vega, is back with a strategy and some of your questions. Now, this can be a whole new world for a student who's moving out of the house where everything's been taken care of them and out on their own. Let's talk about the real elephant in the room, which is the bathroom.
Absolutely. Bathroom etiquette. First of all, you probably want to start by taking a look in the mirror and making sure that you're being a good roommate. Are your bathroom practices what you would want to share with? So, you know, things that you need to maybe consider, you know, corral the hair that is in the sink, you know, take a tissue and collect that out of the shower, or even wipe down the sink after you're done. We keep a roll of paper towels underneath our sink, and that just helps also with the big cleaning job every couple of weeks. Just wipe it down when you're done and it's ready for the next person.
Okay, here's the major question. Does the toilet paper roll over the top or over the bottom? I mean, this is serious.
That might be something that you would want to discuss with your roommate and see what preferences are. Maybe one time it could go over and one time it could go under, but bottom line, replace it.
Yeah, keep the lines of communication open. So let's talk about, you decide some ground rules. How do you make ground rules?
You know what? Start with having a conversation. Have a conversation, set the norms and expectations for what you want, what your roommate wants, and have that open communication at the beginning, and that's going to save a ton of headaches. So, you know, talk about cooking late at night. You know, you might be a night owl and your roommate might like to go to bed early, and yeah. So if you get hungry at 11 o'clock and decide you're going to whip up something in the kitchen, is that going to bother your roommate? So have those conversations early. You know, music, do you need to wear headphones? What about inviting somebody over? You know, establish the ground rules in the beginning to solve problems down the road.
And if you're in the kitchen, you don't leave dirty dishes in the sink. I mean, it sounds like a given, but it's not.
It sounds like a given. Again, are you being the roommate that you want to share a room with? So clean up after yourself.
Now, this is one that would probably affect women more than men, but I'm talking about borrowing, whether you're borrowing clothes or borrowing, you know, their toothpaste or whatever the case may be. How do you solve that?
Well, first of all, that's a slippery slope.
Yeah.
So be really careful. And again, have those conversations about what's okay to borrow and what isn't okay to borrow. And if it's clothing, make sure that you return it as soon as you are finished with it in as good as condition, if not better. If it's food, set ground rules. You might need to maybe make space in the refrigerator for your stuff and your roommate's stuff. You know, have separate sections or something, and maybe even in the cabinets. But have those conversations about what is okay to borrow and what is not okay to borrow.
My niece came up with a good idea when it came to toilet paper and paper towels and things like that. They just all put money in a fund and bought from that fund. And then when the money was gone, they put more money in, so it stayed even.
Great idea.
Yeah, it did work out well. So here are a few questions from actual roommates with problems. My roommate thinks I'm a mind reader. She exploded because I haven't helped pay for cleaning supplies. Well, this is kind of what we're talking about, isn't it? Isn't she responsible for speaking up respectfully earlier?
And again, I'm going to go back to having that conversation earlier. You know, and in this case, it sounds like they didn't have that conversation. So stop now. Apologize for any miscommunication. You know, be open and honest about it. Be nice. You can say just about anything you want to say. It's how you say it and with your word choice. So be open and honest, apologize, and set those ground rules for moving forward.
This person says, my roommate has had a lot of friends but never asks me to go along when they go out. She says, I'm feeling very left out, but I'm worried about asking myself along. What do you advise?
You know what? I think as long as you do it in the right spirit, without sounding, you know, needy or being the victim. Maybe your roommate didn't even think about it. You could just say, hey, the next time you all go out, if there's room, I'd love to tag along. And maybe open the line of communication that way, because your roommate may not have even thought about it or assumed that you wouldn't have enjoyed what they did.
It's a trial run with roommates. You just got to take it easy.
Conversations, open communication, key.
Expectations. There you go. CarrieSueVaga.com. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.